Grades. I give myself some grades. I'm 4 drinks in now.
It's a lot, yeah.
I've been smoked up in since like September. So pause drinking. Thank you. Thank you, DJ. I forgot his name for a second. Thank you, Jason. One more time. Put your hands together. Your next comic on the stage to rock out for 8 to 10 minutes. Jonathan J.
Stronger for this shit, baby. I'm feeling it hungry. It's so clean. Call a nigga.
Heavy is the head that wears the crown. Indeed. Sometimes I feel like the world is too much to carry. Anyone else?
Yeah.
Recently, my sister and her kids fell into some hard times, and I've agreed to take them in, and I had to set up some ground rules for my nephews. No running, no jumping, no yelling, no talking, no walking, and they have to address me as Uncle Bernie, even though my name is John. I recently brought them to my house to look at it. You know, I told them about all the cool things I have on the walls. I got TVs on the walls. I got cool art of like action figures and cartoons and things like that. And, the younger one, his name is David, he looks around at all the cool stuff and he goes, "You live in here all by yourself?" I go, "Yup." He says, "That's sad." I guess apparently the world looks different from a kid's eyes. I thought I was doing it up having my own apartment in New York. Now, why do I have this big apartment to myself? Why do I have this cool room with a whole bunch of cartoons on the walls and things like that? Because I'm a dad. Any other parents in here? Not many? Good. Smart. Smart people. I'm a father of a teenager, 17 years old.
Woo!
I had him when I was 17 years old. I'm a statistic. They called us fucking idiots. We were called teen parents back then, is what they called the statistics. But we made it out. I'm 35 now. My kid's 17. He had everything. He was in one of the top performing arts schools in New York. Rooms his favorite color. TVs on the walls. Vacations every time he had a break. Fucking braces. I was fancy. Recently this summer, you know you're fancy if you kick out braces. So if you guys didn't grow up with braces, or if your kids don't got braces, just know we know as parents. That's baller shit. Anyway, my kid couldn't appreciate it. This summer, he went down to go visit his mom in Florida and his little brothers. You know, pillow fights, fun games. And he decided he didn't want to come back and live with dad in New York. Can't go out there and get him. He's 17 years old. Can't argue with his mom. I done enough of that shit. I'm at 17. I'm right near the end. It's difficult when you're trying to raise a child and both of the parents aren't on the same page. When the situation is like that, the kid pretty much raises himself. And I don't know if you guys know this about kids, but they're stupid. For instance, before my kid left, he had told me he had a project that he had to do on a famous Latino anywhere in the history. His choice, Cameron Diaz. Cameron Diaz? I didn't even know her last name was Diaz until I said it. That's a very popular Latino last name. Does that mean she was supposed to be the Latina flame in Charlie's Angels? Nothing makes sense. And it's crazy how Charlie's Angels was the first time we got to see what pimping was like on national television. I don't know if you guys remember, in 1969, a book came out called Pimp, written by Iceberg Slim. Shit was everywhere. No more than 5 years later, a new TV show comes out. What's it called? Charlie's Angels. It even sounds like a strip club now, right? Both of these things are about mysterious men making women do outrageous things and very skimpy clothing. Good morning, Charlie. These are hoes, guys. I let my son do his project because obviously his stubbornness is what's going to get him through life. I decided to look more into this. And I realized and learned that although Cameron Diaz was born in L.A., she did come here from Cuba. The family isn't Cuban. Their dad's actually Spanish. He's from Spain. And the Spaniards are not Latinos. Now, Latinos are Puerto Rican, Dominican, Cuban, Panamanian, pretty much anyone who speaks Spanish and doesn't look awkward saying the word nigger. And Cameron Diaz...
No.
It's not one of those niggas. So he failed the project. I turned the internet off in my apartment. Grades aren't up, the internet goes off. You get to use it when you come home, do your homework, and then it's off, right? He comes up to me after about a good 3 hours of this. He says, can I download a game on the phone? Oh, he has to ask permission to download games on phones. I told you, I don't play that with his parents shit. So he says, can I download a game on the phone? And I go, no, the grades aren't up. It's not happening. He goes, why not? It's free. Free? No, that's not what I did. I did this. Free? What is free? I paid the rent. I paid the electricity. I paid for the cell phones. He has an iPhone, so I have to pay extra for this shit. What is free? Tell me what is free. I want to know. I'm dying to know. To quote the great philosopher Mark Anthony, tell me, baby girl, because I need to know. I'm quoting the wrong Mark Anthony, but you guys get it. Heavy is the head that wears the crown. I feel extremely unappreciated. So wildlife, it's a new year. New things are happening. On my block, there's a fucking weed store now. Zaza Central. You guys see these stores? It's so weird to me. I refuse to go in them. I went in one once. It was too well lit. They have jars in there with magnifying glasses on the top. Nice pretty girl behind the counter. What kind of car are you looking for today? We have many different types of flour. Flour? No. I prefer my drugs illegally. I want my shit sold to me outside of this weed store, in an alleyway, by a man who I don't even know, a fucking stranger. I don't even want him to have it in bags. I want him to rip off of a larger plastic bag and just twist it to your thumb on it. That's the fucking weed I want. This shit is prepackaged now. In a factory? How did this even get closed like this? I want my shit by a man in a tinted Honda with a big fucking cross tattooed on his face. And it's crazy how Jesus died on a cross and we decided to use that to commemorate him. It's the worst time in this man's life. He's done amazing things. He turned water into wine. We could have had wine glasses and shit like that. Everyone wearing iced out fucking crosses. Fucked up. Let's just say a group of kids rolled up on me on skateboards and beat me to death with it. And then after I died, everyone just started wearing iced out skateboards on me. It's Some of them even got tattoos of skateboards. Maybe with me underneath, with my fucking arms out, sad, crying, bloody, and shit like that. I'd be pissed. If anyone in my neighborhood did that, I wouldn't come back either. Take some time with it. It's a joke about Jesus coming back, but he's not. He's not pleased with us. Have I been up here enough? There we go. I thank you guys for listening to my shit. And hopefully some of you understood and can relate to me. I hope this year brings you guys a lot of comfort. I hope you guys find everything that you're looking for. And I hope nothing is too far out of reach. My name is Jonathan James. You guys can follow me, International EA. I thank you guys so much for having me. And have a great night.
One more time, John.